let's talk about diets. So there are a lot of diets: high fat, high carb, raw, plant-based, this, that, and I would like to clarify something about them, at least what I think. And the thing is, most of these diets are not inherently bad, but there's a catch. You have to follow them properly. Let me explain. So your body needs certain things in order to survive, and then it needs certain things to function better, to function more optimally, to thrive. And this is really important. We don't want to survive, we want to thrive. And thriving is different for every single person, I get that, but let me give you a few examples of things you may relate with. That one day you went to sleep early and woke up much earlier than usual without feeling like complete shit. But that day when you had a great breakfast, you know, some eggs benedict, maa ke haath ka fresh garma garam poha and some chai or coffee with some toast. Or that one day when you literally felt like working out, got in a small workout and all of a sudden started enjoying it. And these things, sometimes small, sometimes large, are the ones that actually go beyond survival. They help you thrive. Not only does your brain fog disappear, but you actually feel better, you feel more energetic, you feel more agile, you want to move, you want to do things. You literally start feeling like your mind and your body are in sync and both of them push each other to do better. You basically go from surviving to thriving. And while you cannot be in that frame of mind all the time, there are ways you can go there much, much, much more often and stay there for longer. A lot of it has to do with your diet. And no, you don't need to be eating some weird diet food, plain raw vegetables or any of the other diet stuff you see. And this is where I would like to talk about diets. The raw, the vegan, the keto, the intermittent fasting, and all of these other diets that keep popping up. In a lot of diets around the world, even in the cities where you have access to practically anything and everything you can possibly want to eat, you are deficient. Iron deficiency, 1 in every 4 people is deficient in iron. Similarly, omega-3, vitamin D, B12, iodine, and a ton of other things. A lot of people around the world are deficient in a lot of things, and that means maybe you and I are deficient in something or the other. Now, keeping that in mind, a lot of these famous diets, the keto, the vegan, the fasting, all of these have a lot of scientific basis to them. They all have research talking both about the pros and the cons of a diet like this. And this is where I would like you to bring in some common sense. Some of these diets may work with the lifestyle you have, some may not. Some foods in these diets may be accessible to you or may not. And there are people, really, really high functioning people, who swear by ketosis, who swear by intermittent fasting, who swear by all of these different diets, and some of my favorite athletes have shifted over to being vegans. And it is working for them. And here, I would like to talk about the most important point, the point this entire video is actually based on: the quality of your diet. How well do you actually follow your diet? I started off by saying that a lot of people are deficient in something or the other. You can follow one of these diets and be deficient or not, or you can not follow any diet and be deficient or not. The goal, regardless of what diet you follow, and that's the key, regardless of what diet you follow, is to not be deficient. Yes, veganism causes deficiencies in some things. So does fasting, so does keto, and so does not following any of them. Now, regardless of what diet you follow, some balance needs to be maintained. Your first priority is to get in all the nutrients that you need. And here's where the problem lies. Some diets restrict you from eating certain foods, and while I don't agree with it, while I don't personally recommend restrictions, they work. They definitely work, and they work better for some people. So I completely understand why they are there. But keep in mind, before throwing around that one point that vegans are deficient in B12, you may be too. And understand, the problem is not veganism. The problem is that very few of us actually eat the way we're supposed to eat the micros and the macros the way we need it. We are eating in order to survive, not to thrive. And your diet plays a major role in how you feel and function. The difference between you feeling like absolute shit and you feeling great is what you eat. If you don't want to feel like shit, don't eat shit. And see, what you eat chemically affects your body. If you don't get all the nutrients you need, your hormones won't be in control, you won't sleep good. And just to drive this point home, this will eventually lead to depression. you feel weak, tired, sleepy, moody, unhappy, and eventually you won't want to get off your bed and you will get depressed. And there's an overwhelming amount of science that says the same. So what's the point of the video? The point of the video is that regardless of what diet you follow, doesn't matter what diet, and not following a diet is also a diet, a balanced diet, whatever diet you follow, you need to follow it well. You need to limit your deficiencies. Realistically speaking, you can't eliminate them completely, at least not so easily. So what's the next best thing that you can do? Limit them. Limit them to the best of your abilities. And as long as you're doing that, what diet you choose to do that more or less remains useless. Choose whatever diet you want, choose whatever diet makes you feel better. In the end, no diet is really good or bad. It depends on how well you're following it. And not following a diet can also be done badly, which most of us are doing. You can either choose some diet, half-ass it, and survive, or you can choose a diet, any diet, follow it right, and thrive.